Good evening and welcome to October 27th, 2016 Planning Board meeting. First item on the agenda is a site plan review continued for Gary Remillard, North Riverdale Road.
No.
Maybe he's not.
We're going to do this first.
Is he here?
Yeah, right there.
Oh, that's him?
Yeah.
Okay, we will do that first. We will do that first. Should be easy. Yeah, you walked 15 feet extra, but the ground trip, I'm sorry. We have a request for a stone wall removal on Winslow Road. See, there we have it. Which lot is lot number 124?
There are some color pictures down here. I just gave you the black and white so you can really get this going on.
Is that old real estate for all time? That's not bad.
Yeah, maybe he hooped it in the pucker brush after he bought it. Where is Winslow?
No.
They're all the same place.
Off of Upper Granny?
Like that.
Yeah.
That's that.
Granny. You go up Page Hill, Granny goes to the right.
Okay, yeah.
And then Winslow goes off to the left. And it dead ends and comes back out on Reservoir by the cemetery. Thank you for these.
No problem.
So it appears you have an existing 10 or 15 foot wide opening. You want to widen it to make the 30. Yep.
What's the lot number?
124. It's just 2 acre lot. And this driveway is basically across the road from the other driveway.
It's across from another driveway.
Yeah. I know Neil's going to ask you the question, so what are you going to do with the rocks when you remove?
Basically, if you're looking at the driveway on the left-hand side, there's like a low spot in the wall. You're going to stack them on top of that. That way, you know, because they're all weathered and stuff nicely.
Good answer. Thank you.
Want a motion?
I do.
I move we recommend approval of this to the selectmen.
A second.
Discussion? Oh, jeez. I need to appoint John as a voting member before we finish this.
You have enough of Tom. You still need me?
I don't need you, but we'll take it.
Okay, fine.
Further discussion. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Abstained? See, that was painless. Thank you.
All right, thank you.
I will pass this on to the selectmen. Yeah, you can leave that. That's where he
put. Okay.
Chip, do you need his color issues back? Or do you
want but
yeah, for the selectmen. Ship them down.
And now we'll...
They get lost on the way.
And now we'll move on to the site plan review for Gary Remillard on North Riverdale Road. We have not accepted this application as complete yet. I looked over it this evening. I didn't see any waiver requests. We basically just opened a hearing, scheduled a site walk, closed the hearing. So we need to go through the process of accepting this complete.
we have the minutes of the site walk meeting?
I do believe I sent them to everyone.
They're short.
Yeah, I just want to make sure that...
I had them right at my fingertips. What happened to them?
Once I send them to you guys...
You don't worry about them anymore.
No, I put them in a file and...
Well, the sign or the existing vehicles.
Well, before we get into too much discussion, we need to accept it as complete. Unless you're, that's what you're questioning.
Does he need papers?
Nope. No waivers requested. I didn't see anything going through the checklist.
Mr. Chairman, I move we accept the application as complete.
Second.
Discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Abstain? Opposed? Your application's been accepted. Mr. Dahlberg?
Thank you. Mr. Chairman, we did have a site walk about a month ago. We all stood, you guys that could make it, we all stood pretty much where the building was going to go. For the record, I've heard from a few people that some of the others are quite concerned that we're going to be on a gravel pit or pile of trees or anything like that, which is not the case. All the excavation on site has been done 25 years ago. All we want to do is construct a second commercial building in the location shown. And as a result of the site walk, there is an existing heavily treed buffer to the south of the proposed building. We added a note to the plan to say that all the trees are to remain. We added the building height per the site walk, and for the existing sign, we made reference to note 9 that the existing sign is going to be used. We don't need any waivers. We don't need any special exceptions. We have our septic approval from DES. We don't need any shoreline permits because we're not in within the 250-foot protected shoreline area. It's a 5,088 square foot building, a potential for 5 bays, multi-tenant. At this point, there's a possibility that one tenant might take 3 bays, so there'd be three new, potentially new businesses there. The entire site is a Group 1 excessively well-drained soil. To address the increase in impervious area, we've added 2 leaching catch basins in the location shown, and as explained on the site walk, to get that additional flow back into the ground per the ordinance. The existing common access way is certainly adequate in its width and its grade. Other than that, it's a very straightforward application. And I'll put it back to the board.
Note 11 says lighting to be downcast. Area lights at entrances, parking areas on building as shown. I don't see any.
Yeah, or we did not get the man door locations. I can get the foundation plan or the construction plan from Gary, and I can get those.
Are they all going to be on the building?
Yeah, there are not going to be any freestanding lights. It'll all be on the building.
Okay, so note 11 needs revised just to say that on a building, basically.
I'm not familiar with the term. On the side of the building, proposed effluent disposal system, is that?
Septic system.
Thank you.
We had a comment from Conservation. I had an email from Conservation. Said they noticed some wetland delineations but couldn't find a stamp or note regarding who conducted delineation work. I believe you said on the site walk they were taken from the adjacent site plan and Gove did the environment, did the delineation?
That is correct. There are no wetlands on site. Sorry. And they're more than 50 feet away. So. These lots are grandfathered anyways? They're still pre-existed?
Well, they still have a buffer.
Well, we're...
But either way, you know, wetlands and...
So we're not proposing any work on the adjacent lot, which we no longer own. So I understand the comment, but it's really not germane.
Could you just add a note saying where you got those wetlands from?
Yep.
Just clear that up a little bit.
Sure.
We also had an email from PRLAC. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay. Reviewing the site plan. Basically, they have no comments. The project does not involve wetlands or stormwater issues affecting the river and is outside the 250-foot shoreline protection zone. I'll wait and read this when I get there. You said the sign is going to be on the existing... Identification signs on the existing sign?
Well, we're not proposing any new signs, and that sign, I don't remember the size of it, but they have like little...
Yeah, they got little plaques on one sign.
1 by 18 inch or...
Whatever it is, yeah.
Signs.
Could I suggest that you revise the language in 9, instead of saying there will be one freestanding sign, say the existing freestanding sign in the location shown will be used?
Sure.
My note.
You need to have a public hearing.
Yep. But I'm trying to get everybody through their comments before we get there. You have building height 16 feet. It's right in the fold, and I couldn't read it.
It is 16
okay.
feet.
It's either 16 or 18. I couldn't tell.
It okay. is 16.
Is that to the peak or the eaves?
I believe that's to the peak. I will confirm that.
Any other comments before opening the public hearing?
Neil, your suggestion for note 9, what was that again?
What we were told by Mr. Remillard, what he was that he was going to use the existing sign. He wasn't planning on any sign changing. Any sign changes. So I'm suggesting that statement be reflected.
Does it have to be locked in? I mean, if he has the potential to add more businesses, then he has to come back
well,
here.
Well, that sign has room to put 4 or 5 businesses on one sign.
That's why he didn't want to put in a new sign.
Nobody was set up as a board like a plaque for his business.
Okay.
I don't know, like Mike, I don't know how big the sign is, but it's fairly large.
And I was unable to go to the sidewalk, so okay.
Yeah, it's like a multi. It's like going to a mini mall where you have the main sign and
then a bunch of sub businesses underneath. Okay. Thank you.
Anybody from the public like to comment? Yes, ma'am. You have to come up. Please come up here and state your name so Tina gets it, and we have a large live audience wants to hear you also.
My name is Vicki Rice. I live behind the pit 387, which is down by the water. I want to know what type of business is going in there. Can I ask that?
Sure. To my knowledge, it's uncertain at this point because it's going to be a rental. But it's commercially zoned property, so it would have to be allowed in the commercially zoned use.
What is the time frame on noise as far as commercially zoned?
The hours of operation they are proposing is Monday through Friday, 6 to 10, and Saturday, 8 to 5.
So 6 to 10 at night?
Yes.
And that's acceptable for noise?
We haven't discussed that yet, but...
Okay. That's what the rules are as far as in town is what I'm asking, I guess. For commercial property?
I'm not sure it states exactly, to be honest with you.
Isn't that the gray area?
Yeah.
There are no statutory ordinance.
The reason why I'm asking
hour limitations
is,
for commercial.
The plumbing place at 4:15 in the morning when I go out to let my dog out is already in business. They're already, you can hear them opening gates, opening doors, starting vehicles. So I didn't.
Pipes and
I know that's not part of Remillard's now, as far as I know, but I'm just concerned, as far as another.
Is this your house, ma'am?
Yeah.
I was going to say, where's your house again?
She's to the north of the existing building on site.
Here's the...
212-203.
Here's the site. This is Route 114.
My house is right here.
The river is somewhere over here.
Right here.
Yep.
My house is right there.
Got it.
Your house.
And the plumbing place is here.
Yeah.
And the existing Remillard building is here, and the new one would go somewhere in here.
Yeah.
And you can, over here, you can hear the, even from your house here...
Yeah, we're right here.
You can hear this.
Absolutely. And we can hear the trucks blaring their tires at night and burning their tires in the pit, and running the monster trucks and working on their, whatever it is that they work on. So my concern is, you know, how much more excessive noise. I mean, I understand people got to run their business, but at 10 o'clock at night...
Does the plumbing place stay open late?
They're usually out of there about 5:30, 6 o'clock.
Dinnertime.
Yeah, but in the morning, they're there at the crack of dawn. Like I said, I get up at 4:15 and let my dog out, and I can hear gates opening, doors, overhead doors opening. They're throwing their daily supplies and whatever it is that they're doing.
Loading up, getting ready to go to work, yeah.
So you're concerned that this would be...
More noise added to that?
Even worse, because it doesn't decrease the noise in the morning. It might decrease, there'll be no additional noise in the morning, but there could be additional noise in the evening beyond 6 o'clock time.
Right. And it's just my concern on whether there was any rules.
She's concerned 6, 10 p.m.
Do you have any other concerns? We can bring that up later on to the applicant. Or questions?
Not to, no. No, I think I'm good. There's a moment.
Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else have any questions or concerns? Hearing none, I'll close the public comment, public hearing. I did get a, or Chip got a letter, I guess. I thought it was an email at first, but the letter from Michael Haas. He has, trying to figure out where he lives. Anyway, it says, "Dear Mr. Meany, is my understanding your department has been asked to consider a proposal to rezone a parcel of land on 11 River Road, Weare, New Hampshire, for industrial use? My partner and I strongly urge you and your department to reject this proposal and any other that would seek to rezone the land for anything other than residential use. The proposed conversion of the aforementioned property to industrial use and the subsequent increase in vehicular traffic, noise, other activity would greatly and adversely affect the quality of life we enjoy in our home here at 2 Depot Street." I don't really know where that is offhand, but anyway. Oh, okay. "Not 500 feet from the property in question. We moved to Weare in order to enjoy a more peaceful lifestyle than we previously had in the Mid-Atlantic. We'd hate to think that our choice to move in this area was misguided, or that Weare's officials did not value the town well enough to preserve the key assets that it offers its citizens, peace, quiet, and a beautiful countryside. Due to conflicts in work, with work, we will not be able to attend a public hearing regarding this matter last month, Thursday, September 22nd. Nevertheless, I hope you will take our joint opinion into this consideration." I'll give you this. In response, we are not getting, we do not have a proposal to rezone the land. It's zoned commercial right now. It's not zoned industrial, we aren't going to change it to anything. We can't. That's a town vote, but if you can give it to Tina so she can type it up and all that kind of sweet stuff. Mike, do you know the hours that Granite State Plumbing is working offhand?
I do not. I would imagine that on the site plan that was approved, that hours listed. I don't have that in front of me.
Can you get that handed quickly? Or is that a real, no, I didn't think so. Locked up, put away.
Take me till next Wednesday to find it.
I'm not going to sit here that long, but...
I guess the hours on the website is 7:00 to 4:30.
Yeah, I know we had a site plan approved here not too long ago, a year or so, year and a half, maybe.
Oh, that's right. I have nothing to do with that one.
Oh, you do? Okay.
I'm talking about the original one back probably...
Oh, he had another one here.
Late 90s.
Yeah, he had one for another additional building in the back a year and a half ago, and I would assume we had hours of operation on that, and if he's operating it outside of those hours, we should let him know that he shouldn't do that. Whatever the hours are in that plan. I would assume it's not 4:30 in the morning or something, though.
No, but you know, for them to be out of there on the job site by 7, they got to start early in the morning.
Yes, I understand that.
So the business is not open.
That's why you need the 6 o'clock in the morning. 4:30 would be a little pushing it. Thank you. I wouldn't want to be at work at 4:30 because I see them driving home past my house at 5:30, 6 o'clock.
Mr. Chairman, would it be possible, without changing the hours of operation, to put some noise limitations on the evening hours?
I think it'd be very hard to enforce, but I guess it's possible.
The enforcement would be on the part of Ms. Rice rather than anyone
right.
else.
True.
But one of the reasons that we've tried to limit hours of operation in other commercial zones to, say, 9 o'clock has been because we're concerned about the impact on neighbors.
On abutting residential, yes.
And I think the same concept might be applied here.
I mean, after 9 o'clock, all business had to be conducted within the building with the door closed. I mean, that would certainly quiet down.
Mike, do you have any suggestions as to how to help with the late evening hours? Let's put it that way.
I am very sympathetic to Ms. Rice's concerns. I don't know the nature of the business that would go in there. I know what's there now. Sometimes when things come in for repair, it's an emergency. But I think that the suggestion about after a certain hour, conducted indoors with the door closed, is not highly unreasonable. But we don't have a noise ordinance in town yet, and they're not listed in the site plan regs or the zoning ordinance.
Nope. No, they're not.
You really want to stick with these hours of operation, but I'll leave up to the discretion of the board. I haven't been in front of the board for a commercial site plan for quite some time. And if you've been going a certain way, well, you want to go to that way anyway. So, for you and go from there.
Do we already have hours listed for the existing building? And should it conform to that?
No, it's pre-site plan regulation.
So, if we put regulations on this building, then the other buildings, nothing's going to change with that, correct?
Correct.
Well, let's ask Ms. Rice, do you hear noise after 8 or 9 coming from the existing operation?
I think the issue with them is when they, it's almost like during the day, they're not a big issue. They're not big in the morning because they've been there so late at night.
I don't mean the plumbing place. I mean, I'm talking about the existing
other building. Yeah, with the trucks.
Yes.
Their issue is they have monster trucks. They have one dump truck.
Garage.
There's actually two of them there. I mean, Al does his monster truck, and then the bigger bay, I don't know who owns it, has trucks that go in and out of there, and it's more, they're out spinning their tires, they're revving their engines, they're out there. I mean, I can understand if they need to fix their vehicle, but to be out burning donuts in the parking lot, revving sounds, sometimes, I mean, it sounds, I'm waiting to hear a big bang because I'm hoping it'll blow up. Because, they have these monster.
But that's during the day.
That's in the evening.
What is the evening?
9, 10 o'clock at night.
Sometimes. Usually anytime, it's like they do their business during the day.
And then it's playtime after
right.
6.
It's like their personal time where they work on their weekend vehicles or their play toys. And it's not all the time, but it's consistent enough to be irritating. And I don't know why men feel the need to.
Well, don't lump us all together here now.
Most men.
Okay, thank you. I appreciate that.
It's not going to run unless you floor it.
That one, most men think that way. Some.
Yes. I think this new proposed building might actually help that situation because they're substantially reducing the amount of free space there is on the lot to do that by adding this building in there.
Well, as long as it's not three more people that have monsters.
But if we limit, if we put some kind of something that can help with the noise for that, at least they won't be an issue then.
I mean, if you put it to like 6 to 10 or something like that.
Well, the problem is that the application before us is for businesses. Mm-hmm. Regardless of when the business closes down, you're talking about people using that site for personal purposes.
Right.
So even if we were to adopt Bruce's idea of saying business activities after 9 have to be conducted within the building with the door closed.
But the other ones next door could be out burning around the parking
lot. Or these same guys at 10:30 and 11 could be out burning rubber in the parking lot on their own personal vehicles having nothing to do with the business.
Now at that point, can you call the cops?
You certainly can, but my understanding is that they won't enforce it because they don't have any evidence. Well, you'd have to convert that to decibels or something, and then somebody would have to make the judgment that it's unreasonable.
Right.
It's a difficult situation.
But my main concern was what else was going in there and how much more traffic it was going to cause. And I have a 6-year-old granddaughter that we go out bike riding every day. Up and down this road, which now, even when they closed the bridge down further and the traffic had to reroute up our way, the traffic just from that was ridiculous.
No, I'm sure.
I mean, it's back open, so the flow is back to normal, but with 3-6 more businesses coming in and out, depending on the type of business, the amount of traffic that would generate.
Doesn't most of this traffic come from 114 Goffstown?
I would think it'd go straight to 114.
Depends on where they're going.
And wouldn't go past your place.
Depends on where they're going. I mean, my driveway, their entrance is here, there's a house, and my driveway is there. So, I mean, if they choose to go 114, that's fine, but if they go down over the hill, I mean, either way, I go to 114 when I leave my driveway. But my concern is just, if there's tractor trailers or what have you. I mean, people gotta live, people gotta make their living, they gotta have their businesses, I understand that. I just need to voice my opinion.
So could you change the note to say 6 to 10, 8 to 10 be business to be inside, conducted with doors closed?
Say
6 to 10. Monday through Friday, eight to 10, business to be conducted indoors with doors closed. That would be really 6 to 6 outside, basically. Most of those places down there close at 5 anyway, that I saw.
Right. I don't think that's unreasonable. I'll put it on the plan if my client has a gigantic problem. I guess he would have to come in for an amended site plan approval to revive that.
Yep.
I know he wants to get the building going.
Yep.
To beat the frost.
Sure.
So, that's the way it's going to be.
Okay.
Craig, if I can.
Yes.
I actually disagree with that.
Uh-oh.
Having worked in a garage during the summer, after six, it gets very, very hot. And they're not paying for air conditioning.
Nope, they aren't.
Fans really aren't going to be that helpful.
Nope.
So.
Perhaps you could phrase it that any activity that produces unreasonable noise.
It's going to be very subjective, that's the problem.
Yeah.
Less subjective if the door's open or closed.
Because I agree.
I don't think closing the doors at six would be feasible. I thought you said six, I'm sorry.
No, eight. I know that one person, one tenant, another building down there happens to fix my chainsaw.
Yes.
And several times he closed at noon because it was too hot inside.
Yeah.
Well, I think you'll find out that for 5 months out of the year, everything's going to be inside anyways.
Yes.
Yes.
And then when it's nice out, they're going to be outside.
There's going to be a period in July where they're going to want to leave the door open if they're working late, basically. If somebody's working six in the morning to eight at night, I would think they'd be tired by that time and say, yeah, 6 to 10 is really not enough for two shifts, but. That's my suggestion. I'm not speaking for the whole board.
Where are they?
What are they?
Where are they?
Four, three?
Six.
Six, three, four.
Three or six.
It's on page 832.
Where are we at?
Zoning, page.
Zoning, page 8, 3.2.
And that would at least entail, after the formal complaint by Ms. Rice, a letter, if nothing.
I should probably read this so everybody knows what we're talking about, right? Article 3.2 is performance standards. It says, any use of land shall not be unreasonably obnoxious or excessively offensive to an extent that would be injurious to the public health and safety or the reasonable expectation of comfort, peace, and quiet enjoyment of the community or neighborhood, or cause significant disturbance or unreasonable annoyance because of noise, including but not limited to excessively loud music, vibration, smoke, fumes, glare, odor, dust, gas fumes, chemicals, radiation, or other waste materials, or be reason of danger of fire or explosion, or result in reduction of property values in the neighborhood.
So under that, right now you would have an opportunity to complain about the plumbing noise in the morning. And that complaint would be to you?
Yes. And that would at least entail a formal letter written to the owner of the business advising them that they were a disruptive force in the neighborhood and could they please stop.
And
or clank less when they're loading their truck.
Yeah.
And
start loading the truck at
and
six
regardless of what we do with respect to the Remillard application, that same standard applies. So that if in fact right now the wheelies that are going on are a problem for you, at least you could try to write Chip a letter.
So I would just write a letter regarding my issues and
yes.
Here.
Go online and check Article 3.2. So you can kind of figure out exactly how the article's written and what it covers. And then you would come into my office and get a formal complaint form. Fill it out.
These are Article 3.2?
Yep.
And I just go on the town website?
Yep.
It's under town ordinances, then zoning regulations, zoning, yes.
It's the town zoning ordinance, that's its name, zoning ordinance.
Any other comments or suggestions? Do you have those minutes that I passed you today?
I think this would cover it, rather than trying to put something else in there. Even for those people who are out doing wheelies, after their business closes, the same thing would apply, right?
Yeah.
This isn't strictly
smoke, loud noise, fumes.
Loud music?
Yeah.
Does it only apply to?
It applies to everybody.
Yeah, it doesn't, yeah, it just applies.
Yeah, applies to me, applies to you, applies to everybody.
Once it comes to site, I think we have to have this on site, whether it's personal or not.
Right, well, you've.
Well, all of the land in town is subject to zoning.
Right, so it's the whole, everything.
Not just.
Well, I understand, but to directly address the commercial use next to a residential house, his rights certainly has cause.
It's like me filing a complaint with Chip for excessively loud music coming from a party down the hill.
Which the police will go and enforce.
I'm not gonna complain to anybody, Chip. Well, it is loud sometimes, but it's all right.
I, from my perspective, some sort of a litmus test has to be applied. If you're doing wheelies in the middle of a residential zone, that's one thing. If you're doing it in a commercial zone, that's another. How many people are offended? One person could be enough to at least entail a letter being written saying, please curtail your activities.
And that's a start.
And yeah.
Maybe.
And a lot of times that's enough. Most of the people.
They may not even know.
Take your husband, for example, I'm sure. If I sent him a letter and said, you're making too much noise, he would probably grumble and complain, but more than likely he would curtail his activities at least for a little while. So, you know.
So that would be something that if I wrote this letter regarding the excessive with the trucks and the plumbing company in the morning, I did that, letter was sent out or whatever, 2 months down the road, there's two or three
again.
Days consecutive
send,
up there doing
send
it
Send another
again.
Letter and the tone of my letter becomes stronger
I
than...
I mean, I don't want to be nasty to these people, but sometimes there's just, it's just obnoxious.
Especially during
hours,
the summer.
Hours of
But remember that they may not be aware
but, no,
that it's
death.
Affecting you.
They're probably deaf. So would I take a video of them? Spinning their tires, if I see them up doing donuts, do I take a video for evidence?
No, if it goes that far, then I think that the police may have to be involved in that. But for me, it's, you know,
the letter of what's going on.
As long as you are being reasonable in your request, I can be reasonable when I deal with them. Mm-hmm. And for the most part, I found that when all parties are being reasonable, you can come to a mutual meeting of the minds. More easily than if you screamed at me and then I go scream at them because I'm mad because you screamed at me.
And I know more of the trucks and stuff are done during like mud season. They have mud trucks and they have the whatever fair times where they bring these trucks to monster pulls and stuff. So they're, you know, I understand they're trying to get them ready for whatever it is that they're doing.
Yeah. Also,
so it kind of comes in waves.
I think that Mr. Remillard, and I know in the past I have spoken with both the Remillards about curtailing certain activities down there, and they've always complied with what I asked them. And I doubt that the Remillards are going to be overjoyed to have people with monster trucks tearing up the gravel in that parking lot.
I don't understand why they don't see the marks, but maybe they just... Because there's tar there too, so there's, you know, they make the marks on the tar too.
Yeah.
There's a black Chevy truck that goes zooming in and out of there, burning his tires. There was a yellow one the other day.
Is there an entrance to this site near your house?
It's.
Or you're talking about the one off.
Yeah, there.
Her driveway. Her driveway is here.
Probably.
That's your driveway.
That's your driveway.
From my.
Back here. Yes.
Wow. That I didn't understand.
We're back
is that right? Your driveway goes right down the power line, basically?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, Ferris's, yes. Tracy's house is the only thing in between.
And when we're coming down our driveway, there's no trees because public service cuts them all down.
Right.
So we can see right into the pit. I mean, trees on our line, we keep as tall as we can so that we have a buffer between us and the pit, but, I mean, you know.
Your driveway is in the public service easement and everything, so they keep everything clear.
Right, right. So once it starts getting built up and we get a little buffer on that side, they come in and cut it down.
You ready for the motion?
I am, I think. Yes.
One question first. Mike, there's nothing in here about removing all those vehicles. And that was, and I don't know if it's appropriate, but he did state it at the sidewalk that he was going to remove all of the vehicles that were in that graveled area off-site.
Well, those aren't his. So they're, I believe, but they are his sons.
But they're there at his, he's tolerating their existence. And if he...
Not anymore. Put up a new building.
Well, are they gone? Or are you just saying?
No, okay. They're not.
A lot of it, well, before you got there for the sidewalk, from the edge, pretty much from the edge of pavement up to that tree line, that was full. That was covered with 1936 Mack dump trucks and old, you know, antique loaders.
Where'd they go?
I'm not sure.
On the street.
Where?
Well, some of those pieces of equipment, even though they're rusty and beat up, are quite valuable. That's somebody's collection. And it's not junk. That's... A lot of the stuff is worth a lot of money.
But it's no longer on the site.
Well, it's not going to be if he goes to build a site plan and wants his certificate of compliance. I mean, occupancy. So if you want to tie the CO to that, fine.
No, it's not necessary. I don't even want to put it in. But I just wanted to know
I
what in fact was going
all
to happen.
Be gone. One, he needs to do that for traffic flow per the site plan.
Yeah, for his parking spaces and all that, because it's all one of the
got it. Spaces. Okay, fine.
Why not have it all put back here behind the fence?
Sorry, what?
Why not have a note saying that any existing vehicle storage has to be to the north side of the property behind the chain link fence? I think that's what that is.
Well, what do you mean by vehicle storage? What if someone comes in here and they're going to do, you know, custom car restoration?
Okay. Thank you. I never thought that. Yep, sorry. I was thinking of the not quite junk vehicles.
Yeah.
I'm not business related, sorry.
Yeah. Ready for motion?
I am, yes.
I move we approve the application, Mr. Remillard's application, with the following changes. An additional note indicating where the wetland data came from will be added. Note 9 will be revised to say the existing revised freestanding sign in the location shown will be used. And we're not going to do anything.
No.
Okay. Period.
Second.
Discussion. Could I add one thing to your motion that note 11 be changed to say lighting to be downcast area lights?
Yes.
Only on the building as shown, and then that would be another condition, would be show the lighting on the building. That'd be two more, actually.
Yes, I accept that. Okay. Proposal.
You
seconded.
Thank you.
Discussion. We're not gonna modify 17. We're not gonna do anything about garage doors, correct?
Correct.
No, that's not
the
motion.
There seems to be another avenue
with 3.2.
With 3.2 to deal with.
Okay.
Further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
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 Opposed? Abstain? You're approved, sir.
Thank you.
This happens every time. Lose my
head.
The next item on the agenda is a subdivision for William Anderson, 137 East Road. I couldn't find my stuff on that.
Here.
Thank you.
I took it from Bruce. If you were here last night.
Do we get any paperwork for this?
Then you were shorted.
I handed them all out last, 2 weeks ago.
I wasn't here. Perfect.
I just threw my stuff today and I couldn't find it.
Would you like me to make you a copy?
Mr. Neal was nice enough to lend me his.
Wait a second. Is this the former Jockey Brown land?
Yes, it is. On the one side of the street.
Didn't he give a lot of that land to the town for a cemetery addition?
Yeah. That was a little confusing to me where there's headstones in there from the 1800s, but yet the deed goes back to the 1960s.
No, but I thought he also gave some open land that was to be used for spreading ashes.
I found nothing in the deeds when researching this property. There's area within that cemetery that does not have headstones. Possibly it could be in there, but I didn't see anything in my research explaining that.
Do you know anything about that town?
I'm talking about two different sides of the road here.
Yeah.
No, I'm not talking about the barn side of the road.
Two different sides of Buzzle Hill. There's cemeteries on both sides.
Yeah, what you're referring to, Neil, is the side with the barns on it. That whole issue there, the donation, the easement, everything is all on the side with the barns and behind it up the hill.
But none of the land adjacent to that cemetery was given to the cemetery for a field in which people could dispose of ashes as opposed to having their loved ones buried.
No, it was all on the right hand side of East Road as you're coming from the Weare Center.
There's the barn. So that was all back here.
Even if there were such an easement, we're not proposing to do anything in the field. So in theory, that easement would still be on the property and what we're proposing wouldn't affect it. But again, I don't believe so. That easement.
So you don't know anything about that, Tom?
I know that whole transaction was on the right-hand side of the road going down East Road. Nothing across the street was affected by that.
Okay.
And we're talking about everything on the left side of the road.
Correct.
As you're going east on East Road.
Correct. Yes.
I probably should be doing north, south, east, west, left, and right here.
Well, we know we're leaving here and we're driving towards the site, so I'm with you.
So there were no restrictions in the deed that Mr. Anderson has?
Correct.
If it's not there, I guess it's not. Okay. Sorry for raising that.
Not a problem.
It was something that I thought had happened.
Who doesn't like a history lesson?
We do a lot of history lessons in the survey field, that's for sure.
Absolutely. It was walking by the rock that said this was donated in 1960 or whatever that solved the mystery for me. I was just baffled. Like, how are there headstones from the 1800s, but yet this was heated up in 1960?
So now that we got past the easement or lack thereof, we need to accept this as complete before we, the application is complete before we go on. I don't see any waiver requests, I don't see any waivers needed for acceptance.
I'll make a motion to accept the application as complete.
Second.
Discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Abstained?
I'd like to point out on that plan, the wall radiuses are obscenely large. It was a drafting error. They're actually 225 feet when they should only be 75.
I was wondering about that,
actually. I scaled the block, and I'm so used to working on like cluster lots and whatnot where you have to jam everything in. I was like, okay, yeah, I can make it all work. And then after I submitted, I looked at it and I went, ooh. So I revised that on the plan that's here, and I will fix that before the final plan is done.
I was wondering how a 5-acre lot, the 75-foot well radius just barely fit.
Yeah, I'm like, you stare at the screen for so long.
I understand.
You know.
I'm a surveyor too, I understand.
I know.
Yeah, we
figured,
spoke.
I figured you'd appreciate that.
Yeah, we've spoke here a couple of times, yes. Other issues. Yes.
Is there 250-foot frontage for lot 80, proposed lot 83.1?
Both lots have the minimum, yes.
Can you scale that to see if that's right? I can't read the numbers.
You can't scale it downsized.
Well, it's got to have 200.
154.
195. Yeah, he's got it. 195 plus 80.
We can scale this one.
Yeah, you can scale this one.
But yeah, but not
that.
Scale that
one.
195 plus 80, what's that?
More than enough.
Yes. That's what I thought. That's where I quit too. It was more than over 250.
Okay, thank you.
Only two little things I can see is you're going to need to get Selectman approved for the driveway through the stone wall.
Which comes
to us first.
We could move the driveway over, but you kind of have to imagine it as a stone wall. The stones are ground level, but for right-of-way purposes, it is where the wall was, but we certainly will take care of that.
And Tom Carr stamp.
Yeah, I didn't catch up with him before I submitted but that's another item that I'll get before we're finished.
I saw he's on your butters list, so I wasn't too worried about him knowing about it.
Yeah. He's a busy guy. It'd be hard to pin down.
I gave you credit.
Did you get anything from the Conservation Commission on this? Because I didn't see anything.
Nope.
There's a little note we're going to need about the wetland buffer.
As far as the non-disturbance buffer versus the I think in the notes, I believe I put in that there is the buffer in addition to the setback, but I didn't explain what the buffer was entailed.
I just see a buffer line and a setback line.
Yeah, they're both on there.
They're both there, but then not.
So, what needs to be put in? He's got his wetland buffer line.
Yeah, it's. It needs to identify this as no disturb.
I can expand note number.
It just says wetland buffer right here. Mm-hmm. It should say no disturb.
I can expand note number 4 to include that it's a no disturb wetland buffer in addition to the wetland setback.
Yeah.
I'd almost prefer a new note 8.
Sure.
Stands out a little bit more,
yep.
You know. And basically it's just or off of Article 28.9.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Shrink that well radius down?
So I did it on this plan right here.
I was thinking you might want to move that well just a little bit away from that no disturb buffer.
Yeah, oh, absolutely, yeah, no, absolutely.
Now that you got a lot of room?
Yeah. And again, this, you know, this was to prove it out. They haven't quite decided exactly where the house is gonna go, but we'll, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Is that the existing well on lot 83?
Yes.
And where is the existing leach field, do you know?
I don't know, that's why we did the test pit on the, there's no construction approval, given the sandy soil, it's an old leach field, it's still functioning properly.
Somewhere.
Yeah, so we did another test pit, and if it needs something down the road, we'll address it then.
I was gonna ask the board if they had any other questions first. Anybody else have any questions or comments? Anybody from the public have any comments? Jeez, quiet audience tonight. Well, not really. Okay, I'm gonna close the public hearing. The only thing else I can think of is labeling that existing well as existing. So we've got the well radius is the existing well.
Yep, the buffer note.
Buffer note and Tom Carr stamp.
Yep.
Is what I see.
Did you set the monuments yet?
I have not. I figured I'd hold off until we got approval. Didn't want to put the cart in front of the horse.
Well, you only have one or two to do anyway, right?
There's not a lot of them.
Three, four,
yeah.
Five.
And it's gravel, which is awesome for setting monuments.
Especially rebars.
Yeah. And I will set them before I bring the final plan in, so I will change it to monument set with a description of them.
Okay. Any other comments? I'm ready.
I'm moving through the application. Subject to the following conditions, that a new note 8 be added indicating the wetland buffer area is not to be disturbed, that the well radii be adjusted, that Tom Carr's stamp be placed on the document, and we have another one.
Existing well.
Monuments to be set.
And monuments to be set.
And that monuments are to be set and placed on the plat for recording.
In the existing well label. That's just one existing label.
And label. Labeling the existing well as such.
You have a second?
Second.
Discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Abstained? Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Build a beautiful house, please.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Am I correct in assuming we have three things in minutes to approve?
Four, and that, I think.
Four, I think. Four? I missed one then.
I was hoping for that one last time, but I wasn't here.
No.
No, I guess it is three.
I only have September 8th and October 13th.
You found a September 8th? I didn't find a September 8th, so it might be four.
Well, I don't know if it was done.
I couldn't.
Mislabeled.
Was it? Okay. Well, I have it mislabeled as being September 9th, and then I scratched it out with 8, so.
Right, that was.
I'm all confused.
Do we?
It has the meeting until August 11th, July 28th on it, for our 14th that we already did.
Did we meet September 8th? That's when you came over, wasn't it? When you made your Fillmore mistake?
Yeah.
That was the meeting we canceled. Yes, no meeting September 8th. I think. That's what I decided when I was looking for the minutes, I couldn't find them anyway. Oh, jeez.
Did you pick up my little email with the dates for the hearings on it? I was gonna have that read as the minutes.
And the 8th is the correct day, it is a Thursday.
Yeah, I figured out it was 14 days before the 22nd that I have here.
Tina, do you know which minutes we've approved?
The last one we approved was,
August.
August 11th.
Did we have another meeting in August?
That's the meeting I skipped that Bruce came for. And I couldn't find these minutes in my email.
So then the next one would have been September 8th?
Yes, it would have been.
Yes.
And that's the one Benji Knapp showed up for.
Yeah, now I put the link on top.
Did you look at them real good?
Just the part where I noticed the date was wrong.
So it should be the 8th?
It is the 8th, yes.
It is the 8th.
Other than that, I did not pay attention to the rest yet. Because I was hoping you guys did last time.
I understand.
So are we working on the minutes of the 8th?
I guess we might as well, yes.
No, we decided to meet in the week because I didn't bring it for one.
Oh, geez, I don't remember this.
Let's skip the 8th.
Yeah.
We'll do that one next time. Could you resend out the draft minutes for the 8th to us, please? Because I know I can't find mine. And those are...
This is John's.
Those are John's. Thank you. I do have September 22nd, the site walk from the 29th, and October 13th with me, though.
Let's do the site walk, because that's real easy.
It's real easy.
I move we accept them.
You wrote them.
That's right. I can still move.
I'll second.
Okay. And you still moved. Discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Abstain.
September 22nd?
Okay. You've got a whole bunch of changes there.
Not really. Not many, really. On first page, the big paragraph in the middle. One, two, three, four, fifth line down. Mr. Bolt should probably be Mr. Bolton.
Rather than Bolt.
Yeah. And two line, and next line says, Chairman Francisco asked if September 29th would work for everyone at 5 p.m. Can you add a sentence in there? Because all of a sudden we quit talking about that.
Right.
After Mr. Bolt, the next sentence, Chairman Francisco asked if September 29th would work for everyone at 5 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
Then add a sentence. It was agreed to have the site walk at 5 p.m. on September 29th. And I informed the public that they were welcome to attend the site walk. That just makes it official that we were doing the site walk thing. Page 2, paragraph above where it has Frank Colburn in there. Next last line, it says 100-year flood line and correct the four monuments. Don't we mean set the four monuments? We don't correct monuments, we set monuments.
We set them correctly, of course.
Yes, hopefully. That's
so we set correct monuments.
That's the plan. Oh, there's two problems. Next last paragraph, above where it says Frank Colburn in bold.
Okay.
Third line. It says 75 foot of the carport, add the 100-year flood line, and instead of correct, say set.
Okay.
Same page, second paragraph is something John would have picked up on. One, two, three, fourth line down in the middle, it says Mr.
Same page, second paragraph.
Yes, same page.
Mm-hmm.
Fourth line down, it says Mr. Siciliano said there, it should be they.
Yeah, but you did such a good job.
He did. That's all I got.
That ain't too bad.
No.
And you said it was a what?
Well, I wrote one whole sentence that looks bad.
The minutes of September 22nd.
Okay.
Second.
Discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Abstain.
Make you a voting member and you're abstaining all the time?
Yep.
Jeez.
I won't vote this one.
Oh, okay. October 13th.
I wasn't here.
He'll abstain.
No, it says
he's here.
I was going to question that later on.
Yeah, I need to check. Look at these with you. You don't have
to. Oh, go for it. There's somebody else read.
Conceptual review.
Who's seconded on the 9:15 minutes?
Tom.
Tom moved him.
No, then Neil seconded.
Conceptual review in the bolded part, Nicholas and Sarah Smallwood for a kennel in a rural conservation zone.
It should be rural agricultural with a rural conservation overlay district.
Okay.
Technically.
You bring it in the helmet.
Yes.
I looked at that, I was like, what is that?
Where is that?
Yeah, I got
to
find it now.
Where I said it, or?
No, where you just read it.
To the bolded part, it's the header under Roman number 2. There's number 2, conceptual review, next line down, Nicholas and Sarah. Keep going, last word, then the following line. That's all I saw on the first page.
I had, next to the last paragraph, fifth line up, Mr. Klo asked why it would not be a legal use. I had it reversed there. So just insert the word not after would.
Which page do you want, Tom?
Pardon me?
Which page do you want?
I'm on page 1, next to the last paragraph, fifth line up, asked why it would insert the word not,
okay.
Be a legal use.
And then insert the word use after legal.
Yep.
Second page. Middle paragraph. Starting fifth line down, the very end, Mr. Kirk said if they go in for a variance. Did he say it or did he ask that?
Yeah, on that page, just you bring that up there, rather than go through every single one, but there are quite a few pages, places there where if you read through it, you know, you can change a lot of the words said to ask.
Yeah, I got a couple of those.
Like in the very first paragraph, Mr. Dearborn asked if it have been less than 2 years. And then there are quite a few as you go through there, including the one that John just mentioned.
And then the following line underneath that, Mr. Kirk said said for the definition of agriculture, I believe that's probably supposed to be asked for. Based on the way I read this.
Yeah, I think if you just read through, you'll see quite a few places where you just switch those to the word ask because they're questions.
That's all I had on page two.
Down to very end.
So what page do you want, Tom?
Same thing, page two. Fourth line up, Mr. Meany said if we say yes, they can go off and I just crossed out does and put start the kennel.
Okay.
And what?
Start.
Start the kennel. You need some word in there other than does.
Yeah, I put do, but yeah. Start makes more sense. Same page, first paragraph, 1, 2, 3, 4. Fourth line down, the very end, says make a ruling, then make a straight of appeal. That should probably be then make an appeal to the zoning board.
Where are you?
Administrative appeal.
Oh, and administrative.
I was trying to get on the...
That's what she was trying to get to.
I was trying to figure out what the word was, no matter how many times I listened to it.
Administrative appeal?
Yes, instead change straight to administrative. Yes, that makes sense. That was all I had in that page.
Page three. Top paragraph, last line, fifth word in. I believe that's supposed to be an A.
No, I had any.
Or any.
Actually, the first line, too, on the very page, I just inserted the word A. Mr. Meany said he feels they are A, they can use.
Next paragraph, second line. Mr. Meany said these regulations were take it and throw it in the fan.
That's what he said.
Throw is spelled differently.
Not through in a van, throw. Yeah.
And should you actually quote put quotes around that? See, as though I don't think that's a legal definition or a legal term. And then a couple of lines further down, just again, throw versus through. And then, same paragraph, fourth line, towards the end, Mr. Meany said, then how can you limit the number of businesses? Should said be changed to ask? So.
We are going to propose kennels as a use in the rural ag zone.
Yes, we are.
Should we change that to ask?
With a limitation on how many breeding females.
Yes.
Really?
I think we should.
Next paragraph.
You don't want 1,000 breeding females on a 5-acre lot.
I don't think you should have more than 20 dogs total. So if you had four females.
Third line, just change the here to HBRE.
Three have bred and calving at the same time, and they each had a litter of five. There's your 20 dogs.
Third line up in that same paragraph. Change
and they make
where
a lot
to
of
were. Mr. Close said the miniature horses that were there.
You get 20 Labrador retrievers barking.
Couple of other changes.
Yeah, I'm trying to find the last one. The time oh. Was it in that one that I just changed the here on?
Pardon me?
Was it in that same paragraph that I just changed the spelling of here on?
Yes, just go third line up near the end of it. Just change the word where to were. Miniature horses that were there were raised to sell as pets. Funny?
No.
Okay, start. Third line up in that same
paragraphs that Mr. Close said. Got it?
The line starts, horse, comma, pet, chicken.
Okay, page three, bottom paragraph, forget. The paragraph above the bottom paragraph, starting at the bottom.
Not very, lines start out horse, pet, chicken, or pet pig.
You know what we ought to do? Tina, what you ought to do is number every line on these pages. And we could refer to line 27.
There's actually another town that does that. Actually, makes it a lot, makes it pretty easy.
Really?
Allenstown does that, I believe, in Network.
Oh. Okay.
That's what it is, a toggle. Oh, this is a toggle.
On page three, first paragraph, fourth line down, the first two words are expedited site.
Yeah.
After the word site, I think you need to insert the word plan. And then the paragraph that we had trouble finding. But in this time, it's the line above the horse, pet, chicken, or pet pig line. Chairman Francisco said that he is proposing, not proposed.
I've never proposed to a dog. I do love my dog, but nope, I'm not going there.
Maybe legal in other states. I don't think this one.
Did you got that, Tina?
Yeah.
Okay.
I got a comment about your dog later.
Mine?
Yeah.
Oh.
Are we all done on page three?
Yes, that's all the further I got, actually. I got bored when I got to page four.
Sorry.
Page four, under fire.
You
want to
sit down? You want to sit down? You just, oh, not comfortable, okay.
Page four, under fire department. That first paragraph under fire department, middle of the paragraph, starts off, which is $225,000. Mm-hmm. Mr. Dearborn said there is an opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
For some reason, I highlighted that. I don't know why, but I did. Is that right?
I think that probably said there was an opportunity.
That's kind of what I thought.
Yeah.
Because it seemed like present and past tense all around.
Yeah, I think was an opportunity to use a block grant, which was not approved.
So is should be was?
Yes.
And in that same paragraph, that does something.
Oh, go ahead. I'm on to the next paragraph. Go ahead.
Okay. If you go up three lines, Tina, the cost of a new auto, you can see that?
Three lines from the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
Would you insert which would total $100,000? Because that's the actual cost that is going before finance.
$100,000 for a bottle? That doesn't sound
no.
right.
No, cost of each. No, it's the total cost, just mentally, because sell them as certified bottles, which are 40% the cost of a new bottle, which would total $100,000. So the warrant article would say $100,000, not $225,000. I don't think that's clear.
No.
So you want to add the...
I think it would be, if you just right after the word new bottle, which would total $100,000.
So you're talking the lot of bottles, not just an individual one. Okay.
Right.
I see what you're saying.
He's saying 26 refurbished for $100,000.
Yep.
Yeah. Must be a bottle for...
Yeah.
And Tina, the line above that one, at the end it says, Mr. Dearborn is...
Mm-hmm.
It should be Mr. Dearborn said... And I think we should delete the words such as the ambulance or Southwear fire, because I don't remember, I know he mentioned something about that, but I don't understand how that's relevant in this context unless we explain it further, which I can't do.
How about just saying for different departments after the word training?
Training.
Yeah, put a period after training.
Okay.
Because
he was referring to a situation now where they have two different configurations.
Next paragraph, paragraph number, you have it numbered two, which, okay, makes sense now. Fifth line down, starting the voters around town, around the town. Mm-hmm. Town should be voting.
Which page and paragraph?
Page four, last paragraph, fifth line down.
Yep.
Fifth word in.
No, don't hear.
Five down, five in.
And what do you want it to say?
Lower. Should be lowercase.
Yeah, but the...
It shouldn't it be the
lowercase? Capitalized...
In the third line.
In the third line. I agree that
yes.
The whole thing should be lowercase.
I didn't see the one in the third line, but yes. That's all I had in that one.
You could make an argument that T, that town, all the time should be capitalized. Because it's short for the town of Weare.
Let's go on to page five. Now we save ink.
I had nothing on page five.
I had in the, it'll be the third paragraph down, second one under public works, just a clarification, really. The second sentence, Mr. Dearborn said, if they took a look at River Road, I inserted bridge repair rather than reconstruction. They anticipate getting 5 years out of it.
Was that the one they just rebuilt?
It's the one that hasn't been repaired yet.
Oh, okay.
We're anticipating getting 5 years out of the repair. It isn't the road reconstruction, it's the bridge repair. River Road bridge repair.
So substitute repair for reconstruction?
Yes.
Bridge repair.
Bridge repair.
Bridge repair for the word reconstruction.
Yes.
Yeah, I think I picked
pretty
reconstruction
because
that's going how we had
on
the CIP.
Yeah. That's all I had on this page.
Last page, well, we've already addressed the attendance, and did somebody not vote on the adjournment? The count doesn't match up.
Someone could have left.
Yeah, Chuck left.
Chuck left. At what point?
Just
before adjournment.
Yeah, a few minutes before adjournment.
Okay.
It wasn't long before adjournment.
No, like maybe 10 minutes before adjournment or 5 minutes before adjournment.
So was there a gap then between?
It might have been after Parks and Rec or before Parks and Rec.
Should that be noted on here? Yeah, the only reason why I question that is the previous paragraph, motion passed 301, which is plowed and swimming.
Did Frank vote on this? Did Chuck vote on the
it's going to
I don't know, actually.
Four votes, and then all of a sudden, the next vote, we're missing a vote.
Yeah, he must be, because I know it. I would have commented if it was 201.
Yes.
So he had to be here for that vote.
I'm just curious, at what point did somebody leave?
I think it would be a good idea, Tina, in the future, if a member comes in late or leaves, that be indicated in the minutes when that event happens.
Okay.
Yeah, good point.
And then
you could just put...
Well, Mr. Bolton seconded the motion, so he was still here.
Bolton,
but that was a long time.
No, no, it's right there.
Recreation discussion.
No, he seconded the motion to recommend the CIP. Mr. Kirk moved and Mr. Bolton seconded. So Mr. Bolton must have left right before...
So he walked out before you adjourned?
Right.
he was adjourning himself early.
Yes. He had to be in New Boston at 4:30 in the morning.
Gotcha. Okay.
And you probably didn't realize we were going
to... He didn't know we were done.
Because at that time he thought we were going to spend a lot of time on minutes, but Craig decided we weren't, so Frank left unnecessarily early.
That's why I was confused that the numbers didn't match up. So.
Plus we're down to three members.
To approve the minutes of whatever date it was.
October 13th
as amended.
Second.
Discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
Abstaining. I'm abstaining.
Yes, I will.
So.
Who seconded?
You didn't abstain this time?
No.
No, I was here.
I did.
I wasn't here, but I read them. That was your time.
No.
That was mine.
Just wanted to make sure everybody realizes that November 17th is the first hearing for zoning board amendments. December 22nd is the second hearing. And January 26th is the last hearing we're going to be discussing. If you can put that in the minutes, be appreciated.
Is it again?
November, there it is. We've got to make sure we talk about kennels. Neil's looking at signs in that court case, right? That's why I've been forwarding you things, and you keep thanking me for it. I didn't realize if you knew what I was doing that or not.
I did not know that you were looking for...
No, you volunteered.
I will go through the Warner ordinance.
No, the Reed guilt...
The Reed case, I know.
Yes, okay. That's why I was just sending you whatever information I saw along the way. I'm making note to self. Anything else?
Make a motion to adjourn.
Discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. We're out of here.